Yo, what's good? It's your boy JG Tennis back with another video today. So this is gonna be probably one of the longest videos I've ever done, and it's gonna take a while too. A very long while. Now, I know y'all seen my other video where I was talking about my iconic match in Leeds. But now I'm gonna be making this video to be kind of a tour, a trailer towards a football game that's coming in October. So most of y'all already know that I go to Ramsey High School, but I go to these two places that are like far out from my house. These two places are known as Leeds and Springville. I know a lot of people at both places. So, here is what I think about those schools. Leeds and Springville. Leeds, a small town. Springville, also a small town. Two of the best, safest places to live in the state. One place, maybe a small town, but has stuff to do, like going to Bucky's, Outlet, or Bass Pro Shops, Barber Sports Motors, Atrog, so many others things to do. In another town where there may not be a lot of stuff to do, but there's tennis, pickleball, and just find a way to do things to have fun. Me. What about me? Why do I have something to do with both Lee's and Springville? Not just because I'm known at those two places, but why do I love those places so much? Why do I talk about them a lot? Well, because they talk about me a lot, in a good way. And one thing for sure is that they like me being in those areas, so I plan to be in those areas because they love me down there, and they invite me down there, and I accept. But how did I become to like Leeds and Springville? Now you'll see why Leeds is my favorite place in like another video or so, but Leeds. Leeds I've known for like a very long time because I've been down there before. Like I've been to like the Outlet of my mom, some of my dad too, and I would go down there. So, 2022, I went down there as well in Leeds. Not Bass Pro Shops, Outlet. Actually, yeah. Me and my uncle went there, Bass Pro Shops. Now, that was 2020. That was January 2023. We went there for Christmas present. Yeah. And then, my first ever high school. Oh man. My first ever high school tennis match was against the Leeds Green Wave, which y'all probably already know. And that became something that would be one like this. Who would known that Leeds would be a place that I would be known at, I mean, be an icon and to be a place that I would go to a lot. And after winning that match, you know, that match put me on the spot with Leeds, where they, after that match, they immediately put the best player against me the next time we played. After I beat their fourth best player. And guess what? I beat their number one as well. So after I beat their number one, it showed that I can compete with those guys. I can beat those guys. I can win against those guys. Like, I'm somebody that they have to watch out for in the future. And do you know, again, the and ...2023... the next season, the next year, and y'all already know, the iconic tennis match in Leeds. The match, not just like what made in, why is that match so big? Was it, in my opinion, you can kind of say yeah, but it was also a really iconic match because that's what people in Leeds have heard about me so much. Like, that match was heard all around Leeds. Like, every Leeds person, like, when I remember I went to a game, Leeds people told me, asked me, was it for real that you played an iconic match against us? And I said, yeah. And then, you know, after that iconic match, I did my celebration, and that became an iconic celebration where people know me by the iconic celebration. So, next thing you know, I play with good Leeds players, and me and my friends decided to drive to Leeds. Me, Joaquim did, then me, Richard Solomon, then me, Richard Joaquim, then me, Solomon. Leeds became a place that I would go to a lot. Leeds will become my go-to spot if I don't have anything to do. Bucky's, most of the time. For me, Bucky's was always my go-to place. Like, I would get, like, a lot of things. I would get, like, sesame chicken, that's from the other place. Chicken tenders and fries. And usually, like, what I would usually do is, usually I would sit in the car and watch a show. Like, I'll either watch a movie or a show. Let me tell y'all what I did. I watched the whole movie in the Bucky's parking lot. Yes, bro, on my phone. I was watching the Super Mario Bros. I watched that whole movie while eating Bucky's. I know you're like, James, what? I'm like, yeah, I did that. I watched the whole movie in the car. I literally did that. Then, you know, Leeds still was my good spot. But what about the people at the school? What I think about them? I love them. And when I saw the people from the school, like, I have a teammate. Bunch of people at Leeds, like the tennis team, Abram, Sadie, Scout, so many people. And then, you know, they all started following me on Instagram. And, you know, Ramsey played Leeds in the round of 16. And that was a very good game, man. No, it wasn't really a good game. 42-7. I don't know why I said that, but and you know, I would like, you know, me and Sadie were talking about it. We're like, Sadie was saying they're gonna win. Yeah, I went on Instagram and said, "What happened?" As a joke, you know. Then you know, after that, let's go back a while back to October. I had my birthday in Leeds. Me, Richard, Solomon, Joaquin, Jalen Lee. They came to that, like, Jalen Lee came to the, what's it called? The outlet and Bass Pro Shops with us, but then he had to go. Then Chris Bird pulled up. Chris Bird pulled up to the party. He pulled up at Aatrox. We went in there, I was so scared. I was scared. Actually, I was. It's crazy stuff. People were pulling on me and stuff. I'm like, bro, chill out. But, then, you know, December, I decided to I went to Leeds to go buy my parents and grandparents and other people Christmas gifts. So, decided to buy me a Leeds Green Wave shirt. And I'm like, yes, sir. I did that. I did that. And I knew that it was going to be something I'd never done before, but I bought it. I wore. So next thing you know, my Instagram followers went up, and Tennessee then played against Leeds. I beat them, and then you know, did about 3 days or 2 days after spring break, it was a Saturday before spring break ended, and Sylacauga's coach told me about a tennis match between Leeds and Sylacauga. So when they were playing Leeds, I just said that. What am I doing? By the way, guys, it's like 1:45 in the morning. I'm talking to you guys, so I'm very tired. But I'm making this video for you guys. But I went to the match. Like, it was 3:40 after school. Just went to get out of Ramsey school. Wednesday night. Afternoon, I mean. Then nighttime. So I drove. And these people driving crazy. I'm like, bro, why y'all driving so crazy? And I made it to Leeds. First, I stopped at Bucky's. And then I went to the courts. So when I got to the courts, but why did I go to this match in the first place? Like, why did I go to this match in the first place? Was it because it was a big match? Well, actually, yeah. But also, it was because, like, I went to that match was because there's a guy from Chicago who contacted me. Wanted to come play tennis with me, right? Because he's a guy who loves talking to black tennis players. So I decided to go, I went to the match to also go meet him in person. So he can meet me, talk to me, get to know him a little better. And I got to learn more about other people better than ever, too. So when I went to the match, I wore my Leeds shirt. And when I pulled up, a lot of people were surprised. They're like, "What's up, James? Hey, James." Like, my teammate Sadie was so surprised. She couldn't believe it. I was here. I pulled up to the match and I watched all the matches. I watched every last bit of it all the way to the end. And it was an experience for me because I got to sit with the players, I got to talk to them, introduce myself to them. And surprisingly, they knew a lot about me. They knew a bit about me that I didn't even know. Like, they knew who I was and stuff. They said they've heard about me so many times that we all, like, they've said your name, like, so many times. Like, they knew me, who I was. And so, like, some, and I didn't, these are people I didn't even know. And people I didn't know. Now, some of them I knew from Instagram, right? I knew them, some of them from Instagram. But, like, some of these guys I didn't even know. And then they're like talking, saying, "This is James." Remember, that's the tennis player. Like, "Oh, that James." But they love me too. Like, and we did the iconic celebration after. So let me go on this Instagram and look at that. This match. It's aura right there, man. But I love them. I love them for real. And after that match, like, that's when the trend kind of started, when they started inviting me to other matches. Like, they invited me to, like, Jasper and stuff, inviting me to other matches. So that, and then, invited me to the baseball game. So when they invited me to the baseball game, I said, "Yeah, I'm gonna come." So then, we had sectionals there at George Ward, which is where I play at and practice at. And I decided to pull up, like, and I was already pulling up because I had to work there too. Here's this picture. And this picture. And like, after that, I decided to go to Leagues versus Russellville baseball game. And this is how crazy things get, in a good way. When I went to Leagues versus Russellville baseball game, who knew that I was gonna be a big icon? Cause usually I'm a guy that's like, kind of like, I'm just there to go have fun. But who, I didn't know that I was gonna be around a lot of people, and I ended up being around so many people. Like, when I first got there, I didn't really see a lot of people I knew. I know I've seen people that I've seen from, like, Instagram and stuff, but, like, didn't really know them personally. So then, I saw Kenley Williams. And, bro, like, when she saw me, bruh, she started recording. I can't deal with y'all, bruh. Why y'all be recording me when I pull up to places, bro? Like, bro, y'all be like, "Ain't no way James came all the way out here." And they're like, "James is here in the Lee shirt at a baseball game. He's here. He's everywhere." I mean, yeah, I do be everywhere. Like, I drive. Like, of course I'm gonna be everywhere. I be in Jasper, Springville, all that. All that. And Lee's. And, Hoover? Not a lot. But in that baseball game, man, like after that, boy, my IG followers went up. Like that's when I fell in love with Leeds. I mean, I fell in love with Leeds already, but not supposed to transfer there. But I'm staying at Leeds. I mean, I'm staying at Ramsey. So here's me at the baseball game. I'm here with a lot of people. But let me rewind a bit. I went to the soccer game. It was Leeds versus Ramsey. I watched the soccer game. Don't like I went down to that soccer game because one, it was Saturday, right? Saturday, right? Two. When I got there on Saturday, I got to be on the field. Like, I got in for free. I came in with the soccer team. And after the game, I got to meet the goalie for Leeds, Carlos, who's also in that picture I showed y'all. And dude's a pretty good guy. He said he asked me, "Dad play tennis?" I said, "Yeah." And he said, "You know Wilson?" I said, "Yeah, that's my boy." He tells me that you're a dog, that you're really good. And that goes back to the baseball game where so many people came up to me and said, "You're really good at tennis. You're a dog at tennis. You're fire at tennis. You're really good." Like, how do y'all know I play tennis? How y'all know? Now, of course, you know I'm a promoter. I see myself like people. And I promote myself, which is not a bad thing. Like, I go on Instagram and I would just post my success. Like, if I. And that's what, and that's some, I don't know why sometimes people have a problem with that sometimes. Like, I don't brag about stuff. I may say that I'm very known at Leeds, but it's not just always me saying it. It's according to what other people say. Like, one of my teammates said, "Yeah, a lot of people at Leeds know who you are." Even a mom said that. They even said, "Literally almost the whole school knows who you are." They tell people that. I've seen people tell people that I'm very good at tennis. It's not me going up to people and say, "Hey, I'm a very good tennis player." Now, when I went to the mat, I sometimes introduce myself and say, "Hey, I'm James. I'm a very good tennis player." And that's it. It's not bad saying that you're just a really good tennis player. If you're saying you're a really good tennis player, that's not bragging. They're just saying, "I'm just a really good tennis player." I don't go up to people and say I'm better than them. No, I don't ever say that. I go up and say, "Hey, I'm a really good tennis player. I do good." Now, what about people that can beat me and I beat them? Then I would say, I've beaten him before. But it depends on the day. There's days he beats me, there's days I beat him. So, that's all I can say. But, anyway, that baseball game was so fire, man. And I know y'all saw the video, but boy, I was in the, like, first I was in the bleachers, then, like, I was in the student section with everybody else. Like, it was just an amazing, amazing time. Being with those people, being in a student section. I went the next day, which was good. But being in the like with those people, like being with those people on a Friday night, never been some good in my life. So special day. I got to meet more people from Instagram, and my Instagram followers went up too. That's when a lot of Leeds people started following me on IG, all that, every day, every which way. And I became the real known guy at Leeds. And, you know, being, I love the Green Wave for real. Like, I love Green. Go Green Wave. Let's go, Leeds. Ride, Green Ride. I love it. And after that game, they lost it. Like, they lost the first game, won the second game, and lost the next one, but I had to leave. But, not supposed to transfer there again. Like, you know, I changed my whole profile to Leeds. I'm a huge Leeds fan. I'm gonna go to their game, some of their games. I'm excited for it. But now, what about the next school? Springville. Springville. DeVille, one of the best places. Springville High School. Springville's a small town. Kind of near Odenville. Past Trustville and Clay. I didn't hear about Springville, the town, overall until last year. Hey mom, in the background. I see you in the background. Yeah, I need to sit back up. But, Springville. Like, after that iconic match against Leeds, the next match, we're gonna go down to a town known as Springville. And let me let you know this, I didn't know about the town at the time. Now, of course, you know, I was going in, I was kind of nervous because I was like, I don't know anything about the school, but I read about the school kind of, and I said, their tennis players are actually really good. Like, they're really good. Like, it's gonna be tough. And when I first met the coach, like, I know he was kind of like a guy who was like, okay, so we playing to Ramsey, we'll see how it goes, see if we can do good. And for me, I knew that I'm going to have to try to surprise people. I surprised the heck out of so many people that day. So after my first, when I played doubles, we lost some doubles, but then came singles where I played against my bro, Luke Russo. And that match was a match that proved myself to the Springville people. After I won that match, I won 8-1. That match kind of shocked a lot of people down there. Like, they were shocked a little bit. Because really, when you hear about a Ramsey tennis player, you think that they're bad. Or you think that they're not really that good. I mean, not that they're that good. I mean, like, they don't really do good on some occasions. Like, they're at a low level. And they see this guy just whoop your number one. I mean, no. That's bragging right there. Let me rephrase that. And beat the number one in a dominant fashion. 8-1 at the home. And after that, Coach Ken, the Springville coach, came up to me and asked me this. He asked me what grade I was in, right? I told him I was a sophomore. And I was a sophomore during that time. And now I'm about to be a senior, bro. That's literally, time's been going by so fast. But I was a sophomore during that time. I told him I was a sophomore. He's like, sophomore? He was surprised. He's like, you look like you're a senior. I'm like, I mean, people do say that for real. Like, I don't, like, that's crazy to me. A lot of people in Springville look older than they look as well. So, oh, yeah. But next thing you know, why do I keep on saying Leeds? Fear. But next thing you know, I don't really hear back from the Spring Break people again. I talked to them a few, because I didn't really know them during that time. And then, you know, I started knowing one guy, and that was Luke Russo, where I found his Instagram, and I followed him, and then he followed me back, and kept up with each other on Instagram, and then, you know, came the match, right? The first match of the season. He contacted me and said, I told him, see y'all Thursday, right? And he said, can't wait to play you. So, we play our match, right? And it was a pretty good match. I won 10-6. It was a good match. Very well, great match. This was from the first match. Really good match. Thriller. So after that match, my Instagram followers went up from Springville people. Like Braden Henderson, Braden Tingle, Caden Witt, Sarah Colby, Mallory Noel, Spencer Stewart, Jacob Vladimir, Luke Hill, some of these Springville folks. My boy David Jones, my brother. Yeah, but my IG followers went up big time, bruh. And Kier. And during that time, I was thinking, like, what am I gonna do? How am I gonna, like, when I got all these Instagram followers from Springville, some of these guys I didn't really talk to as much as Luke Russo. Now, of course, they said, like, you're really good and stuff, but then, you know, when sectionals came, I got real close with them. That's when Springville became one of my, like, the guys from Springville, like, became some of my big-time friends. And I can't forget to mention Ty Davidson. So those guys from Springville became, like, some of my good friends. Like, first tennis, mostly the tennis crew. At sectionals, I was with them the whole time. Like, I stayed with them all the way to the end. Like, the first day, right? You know, usually me, I'm usually a guy that would not stay for another team, but I would like, go support them. Like, my team was done, because, like, we weren't going to be back until tomorrow, because me and Jabril had to play semifinals of doubles against Jasper. But for me, I stayed at the courts with the Springville people. I stayed there and watched the rest of their matches because, you know, those guys are like my good friends. I hung out with them, talked to them all the time. I got to finally be with them. Because most, like, almost, like, literally the whole team I knew. And I remember my teammates. And that section, I knew so many people, like Springville people, John Carroll people, Jasper people. I was known down in that section. And, you know, my friends from Ramsey, my teammate there asked me, can you help me make some friends down here? And my teammates asked me, how do I know the people from Springville? I told them I know the whole team, mostly from tennis. Mostly from Luke Russo. So I knew most of those guys. Like, most of those guys are my boys. So, next thing you know, after sectionals, I keep up with the Springville people. And after Lee's lost the baseball game to Russellville, there's a game. The Springville girls soccer game. And so I heard, like, when Caden Witt told me about that, he invited me out to go watch that game, man. You know, I had to accept because, like, I want to go see how it is. So, I went out there to go watch the Leeds. I mean, I keep on saying Leeds, Jesus Christ. I went out there to go watch Springville versus Springville versus who? Southside, Gaston, Southside. So I went to go watch that game, and before I went, when I got inside, I didn't really know anybody out here, right? I didn't really know a lot of people out here, because it wasn't like Leeds. Like, because at first it wasn't like Leeds, where like in Leeds, like you knew so many people. Because when I went to Leeds, the Leeds game, I knew so many people down there because they knew who I was. I knew who they were. Most of them knew me from Instagram and all that. Now, in Springville, I was at in the student, no, not yet. I saw one of my tennis friends, and I saw one of Lou Russo's friends. So first, you know, I was in, went to the restroom, and I saw him come up to, like, he saw me, he was like, "What's up, man?" Because he knew who I was. I said, "Are you Ty Davidson?" He's like, "Yeah." So I took a picture with him, bro. And then I finally got to see Caden Witt come. So Caden Witt finally came, and then, you know, I met him, I went into the student section. So I went, when I was in the student section, like, and what was different about this student section was that I didn't know a lot of people during that time. Like, I only knew three people in that student section. When I sat in the student, but everybody was nice, man. Like, they treated me so good. Like, cause they knew I was a guest. They said, "Am I the tennis player, dude? I'm a really good tennis player." And they said, I was a guest. And I enjoyed being down there, like, being in the quarterfinal, being down there. Like, I got to be down there. So, it was something else. After that game, I got gained so many Instagram followers from Springville people. Nathan Baldwin, Patrick Williams. I thought his name was Patrick Willis for a second, but it was Patrick Williams. Seth Jones, Jerome Bird, so many people. Easton Hood. When I went to McDonald's, and Rebecca Sierra followed me on Instagram, Audrey Talton, so many people. And when I went to McDonald's after, I saw my brother David Jones at work. I was, like, eating right, and he came up to me and, like, "Hold on, let me pause this real quick." I was eating on my phone. He was like, "Excuse me, sir. I'm going to have to ask you to leave." And, bro, I look up and I see David Jones in a McDonald's uniform. I'm like, "David Jones? Boy, he's here." So I was in for a bit. Then he had to go back to work. I loved this. I loved being at this game. And after that, Springville won the semifinal. So after that, Springville people invited me out to go watch the state championship game with them. And I didn't know I was going to be able to do that because it was all the way in Huntsville. And it was like another school. But then, you know, I asked my mom and dad. And they talked and they said, "Yeah, you can go to the game." So at first I thought it was going to be at 5 p.m. because that's when the semifinal was. But then I looked and I saw that the game was going to be at 11:30 a.m. And I was like, "God, man, I won't be able to watch it." But then, I did so well in school. So after that, I asked my, like, told my parents how well I was doing in school and everything, and then, you know, like, I asked my mom, "Hey, I did good in this. Man, miss school tomorrow. Today, they all invited me out to go watch this state championship game." And guess what? Guess what she said? She said, "We said you could go, right?" I was just so happy because I'm like, I'm heading to Huntsville to go watch this state championship game. So I got up at 7 in the morning, and I went up to, got gas, and I went up to Huntsville. And when I got to Huntsville, you know, I got in the soccer stadium early, got in there, got me something to eat, and boy, was it a fun time. My stomach was hurting too during that time, but I got it fixed. But after that, I was watching a soccer game. And I was watching the boys, right? The boys championship. It was Gulf Shores and Gunnersville, and boy, I felt bad for Gunnersville being up 2-0, 5 minutes left, and then losing 3-2 in overtime. Double overtime, I think. No, overtime. It was. But then came Springville, and when I got to the stadium, you know, all the Springville people were coming in. Caden Witt came in, then Ty Davidson came in, then the principal. The principal said, "What's up, big man? You riding with us?" I said, "Yeah." I saw the principal 3 times. Cool guy. He also was a Leeds Green Wave guy too. Used to go to Leeds. Like, was a Leeds student. Like, he was a Leeds Green Wave alumni. Still, you know, played tennis. Came to watch tennis, I mean. Saw him at the quarterfinals. Then I saw him at the, championship. So when I got to the championship game, you know, I looked at so many of these great players, and everybody was coming in. I got to see Dylan Harrigan. You know, Dylan Harris said, "James, what's up, man?" Lots of people were surprised to see me back down here. Saw Walker Cole again. He was surprised to see me down here. Seth Jones was surprised too. Jerome, but. And you know, when I got there, when I was there, everybody was like, "Jane, this guy is basically a Springville Tiger now. Like, dude's been, like, this is like the second soccer game coming." I'm like, yeah. I bought me a shirt online. And I was trying to get it before the game came, but it came, like, the day after. It's crazy. But still, interior was to wear white, so I wore a white shirt. So when I got to the game, no, I was already at the game. The game started. Gulf Shores scored. Springville scored first. Then Gulf Shores scored 2 goals. Then one of the Springville people scored. It's 2-1. And it was a pretty good game. I actually got to meet some more Springville people. Like, met Nathan Butlin again. Met Luke Hale. Met so many more people. After that, I became, boy oh boy, it was so fun, man. It was so fun, man. Then, you know, Springville scored 3 straight goals in the second half, and Becca won MVP. Rebecca Sierra. After that game, you know, I was just happy. Like, we were all cheering, man. Like, I think y'all saw the video, I was cheering for them. Like, because, like, yeah. And you know, like, I was at, like, after the championship game. Yeah, I'm trying to show y'all a picture. Let me see if I can find it. Yeah, so it was a pretty good week, too. This is me and Rebecca, state championship MVP. I'm supposed to be playing pickleball with her on July 4th. Her and AT. Then it's me and some of the guys. Got Luke Hill, Walker Cole, Ty Davidson, Kaden Witt, and then me. After that game, you know, the Spring Rib people. And what proved that they loved that I was down there at the game? They said I was their good luck charm and that I need to come to all the Springville games now. Like, they specifically invited me to the rest of the games. And so I'm gonna go. And, you know, just like, I didn't know that I was gonna be close with these people as well. Like, that's when I became more close with the Springville people. So many more people from Springville follow my IG, and a lot of people do from Springville. Like, I got to meet so many good people, so many nice people from both areas, Leeds and Springville. And I go back there often. Like, I go, not often, like, I've been there back there, like, 2 times already. Went to Springville, played tennis with Luke, Braden, and Easton. Hung out with Luke most of the day. Then I went to Springville. I played tennis with Kira, Easton, Mr. Bryan, and AT. AT could have played tennis, bro. But also, I became a real icon down there because now the Springville people started supporting me as well. Like, Rebecca Sierra, really nice person. Like, I know I did a poll one time talking. She said, "Do best Springville athletes." I'm gonna do that poll. She contacted me, and you know, she's a real cool person. Like, they want me to come to all their games. Well, all the games. I can't do all the games, but I'm gonna come to some of the games since it's what y'all invited me for. Leeds people started following me on IG too. Like, it's been happening a lot every day. I've had Leeds people follow me on IG, Springville people, so many people, man. But Leeds and Springville are the two best. Leeds and Springville. That's why I can't wait to announce, and I'm announcing this, I will be at the Leeds versus Springville football game. I'm going to definitely be there. I'm going to be there definitely. I can't wait for it. I'm excited for it. Like, so many of my friends are going to be there. Like, Leeds people are going to be there, Springville people. Like, man, for me, I know a lot of people I know are gonna be on that field. Like, Leeds people, I know most of the people on this football team, know a few of them. Not a few of them, like, I know Wilson, I know Carlos, I know Jonathan, I know a very good amount of people on that football team. And then Springville, I know almost the whole team. Like, most of the team knows who I am, or followed my IG, most of the team I know. So, I'm excited for that, too. Like, I'm excited for it. And, you know, a lot of other people are going to be at their games, too. So, I'm ready for it. Leeds versus Moody, I'm going to. Hope to go to another Springville game, but not against Leeds. I know there's going to be John Carroll versus Homewood. Should go to that game. Homewood versus Parker, Ramsey versus Parker. Playoff games, I can't wait for that. And then the basketball season, I want to go to a Leeds versus Springville basketball game. Hopefully it's on a Friday or Saturday. Now, if it was on a school night, I would probably still go. Depends on what class I have the next day tomorrow. But I love both of them. Like, I'm a real fan of both schools, for real. Like, I'm excited for the next step. Then I go to the baseball games. Hope Springville plays leads in baseball. Probably a soccer game, too. Know a lot of people on both soccer teams, man. And then probably a tennis match, too. I should, too. And definitely the girls' soccer games. If they make it to state again, I'm definitely going. Hopefully. But I gotta make sure the reason last year I was able to go, because I did so well instead of school, I was doing good in my, like doing so well in my grade, doing my chores good. I'm gonna need to keep that up. Because if I keep on doing good, then I get rewarded. But other than that, this is my story. Liege versus Springville. Two different towns. And one guy that's an icon down there. I'm excited for this game. Being down there. These two main areas that I'm known at. And I'm excited for it. I can't wait to be there. I don't know what fit I'm wearing. I think I'm going to wear the Springville shirt and the Leeds hat. Or get a Springville a hat. And then get a Leeds shirt. But I can't wait for it. Well, it's getting late for me. I've been out here for 52 minutes. Been your boy JJ Tennis, and peace out.